Hi, I'm Roxy. Welcome back to my channel. All right. So I feel like there's somebody who's who is worried about coming back, whether they left you or you left them. Somebody's up in their head about coming back. They're really stressed, like for real, real stressed. I want to hide the truth. I want to shelter you. So you might want to go look at the song. I can't think of the actual name of that song. They're kind of worried. They might even come forward and talk to you about what they've done in their past. For some of you, they've talked some trash about you, or they've just talked a lot of ill. And for some of you, I feel like it was because they didn't want anybody to come towards you. They might have even told people that you had an STD or that you were a hoe on the down low. This person's afraid that you're not going to want to talk to them, so they want to come back and apologize. You might even receive an apology from them, and you're like, okay, what's up? Like, some of you might walk away from this person when they tell you exactly what they've been doing, what they've been saying. You're going to be kind of hurt at the fact that this person would go behind their back and really fuck you over. So, and some of you, you might even be able to come out of this. Like, I feel like some of you are a lot more mature than you are, or that you put yourself out there to be. Like, your mind's very open. Like, you're willing to understand, you know, we all hurt people. Like, we all, when we're hurt, we kind of bleed onto other people, not intentionally. So that is a thing. You might want to keep that in mind when this person comes back. I'm not saying accept this person, especially if they're out there talking shit. But, you know, like I said, hurt people, and we tend to bleed on other people when we're hurt, and we're not trying to purposely do this. So this person definitely wants to come back and reveal some type of information to you. For some of you, they're being guided from a past loved one. For some of you, they're being guided by somebody who is a lot wiser than them. Like, they finally sat down and I heard maybe even did a pros and cons about their life. They sat down and really are thinking about stuff. I heard they're up in their head. They might even have had some type of celebration that really made them really think. They're stressed out. They want to come back. Like I said, they want to come back. They want to, like, they see the path before them, but they have to make this decision. They're really, really up in their head. They're cracking, though. There's something about them, actually. Like, the ground is all cracked and dry. Like, this has been over and done with. This is overdue. Like, they've been wanting to come back for a little while, but they've been really up in their head. They've had a lot of dark days. Excuse me. They've been down on their knees praying. Some of you, they've been praying to their God, whatever you believe in. They're asking their gods if they should come back and make this decision. Like, is this the right decision to come back towards this person? Like, I feel like they could really bring me out of these dark days that I'm in. Like, this person, this person feels like this person is your lighthouse. This definitely could be a past person. They just want to leave the negative shit that was happening in the past and move forward. Like, they have some emotions. These emotions have been building. If you are in a pause, well, obviously, if you're in a pause, this person's coming back. Doesn't have to be a long pause. Could be a short pause. But I feel like somebody wants to come in and be honest with the fact that they have feelings. They've had feelings for some of you. They've had feelings when they were with you, but they hid this. They lied about this. I just want to leave the negativity. Like, they're really up in their head. This person might be dealing with depression as well. Their emotions are getting to the better of them. Some of you, they could be hiding the fact that they've got someone pregnant and they're afraid to come forward and tell you this. This person wants to show up to your house. Like, they feel like a ticking time bomb, that they feel like they're running out of time. They might even be wearing white. This person, the way they dress, is something specific about how they dress. They don't dress like normal people. Or they're different. Different from what you're used to, I guess. What you're used to dealing with. There's something different about this person that you're not used to dealing with. Like, this person might be a little snappy with the truth for some of you. They might come in and snap at you and then tell you the truth. This person might have acted like they were over you. They're not. They're lying. These are just Queen of Wands. There's something about this cat in her arms. And that, this right here, this little furry thing. You might, yeah, the way you dress, like, you look like you got your shit together. You kind of look like you got a lot of money. You're very beautiful. You're very passionate. You deserve better. That's what you're thinking. Like, I deserve better. You should have treated me better when we were together. For some of you, might tell this person this. You should have treated me better. Like, some of you, you're going to cut this person off because you don't feel like they're worth your time. Like, you should have treated me better. You cut me off to go towards someone else to put you up in your head. And now you want to come back and work with me. You want to come back and give me this peace offering. For some of you, this person wants to come back and get you pregnant. You're very fruitful. There's something very fruitful. Like, the trees and those fruits are really pulling out to me. You have this gate that you don't just let anybody else into. You might be very exclusive. Like, you're not really one to be out there fucking around with just anybody. Like, you really gotta be worth the time in order to open up that, you know. And they like the fact that you're like that. Like, you're very passionate. You're a very sexual person. But that doesn't mean you just let anybody into those gates down there. You know what I mean? I mean, Jelly Bean. Like, no matter what, I feel like you always are, like, very bright and shiny and happy. Or this person that you're talking to is always bright and shiny. Yeah, they have their down days just like anybody. But you're one of those people who are going to keep going no matter how many swords are put in your back. Yeah, you get knocked down a couple times, but you get back the fuck up and you keep moving. You're taking these swords out of your back. Like, there's three of them in his back, and usually these are all in their back. But there's just a couple left in there, and you're finally getting up off the ground and healing yourself and taking these wounds out of your back and moving forward with your life. You've been pondering this for a while. You've been really up in your head and really pondering this, but you've made your ultimate decision. Like, I feel like someone's finally putting their foot down and moving forward with what they want. Some of you, they might have had to leave someone, or you had to cut someone off that was really making you upset. Maybe they weren't really communicating with you a lot. This person is masking themselves. Like, they, yeah, they had to walk away from someone to come towards you. They had to hurt this person. For some of you, this is what they were up in their heads so much about, because they didn't want to hurt the person they were with. It took a couple tries for some of you, them. It really had to take a lot of drinking, a lot of lonely nights for some of you. Not that that's funny. Like, they were trying really hard with this person that they were with. This could have been a past person they were with, a childhood friend that they were with, or just someone they had some history with. And so that's another reason why it was so hard for them to cut this person out. It was really hard for decision for them to move on from this person they were in a relationship with, for some of you. Or this is just someone they really needed to cut off. I feel like the first time this person met you, the way you talked, I heard soft-spoken. Like, there's something very soft and nurturing about you. You don't even have to be a parent. But the first time they met you, like, actually in person, I feel like I heard even better in person. So if you were talking to this person prior to, and when you finally meet them, or when you did meet this person, like, they instantly fell in love with you. Like, you're so soft-spoken, you're so sweet, but there's something about this person that really intrigues them. And that's what made this decision really hard, because you are, like, you're very drawn in, you're very soft-spoken, you don't let, but you're a very passionate person. Like, you're willing to speak, but you speak the truth. Like, I feel like when you speak with purpose. Like, you're just not out here just talking shit. Like, there, you have a reason to speak, otherwise you're quiet. Like, you're not afraid to speak your truth, that's for sure. And you try to be very caring and loving about it, but sometimes you're like, you know what, fuck it, I'm just gonna speak it. Yes, I'm a little, harsh with my words, but they're fucking true. Some of you, you need to stop being a little, withdrawn. When you move away from these, burdens, you're manifesting this. Like, I feel like some of you are trying to manifest this new start with someone. You've done this before with them. You've done this battle before with them. You've had relationships before with, in a past life with them. You've had a family with them before as well. There's something wise about this person. Your ancestors are giving you this gift as well. I heard this gift of love. They've been watching you. Like, this looks like a mirror, but it also kind of looks like a portal. So the two of you are going towards, through something together, this transformation. You're going to be going through a transformation with someone as well. This, you're giving this person strength, or this person's giving you strength. This person doesn't want you to let go. Like, they want you to hold on. Don't let go yet. Like, I'm still trying here. Like, there's still just this little light that's still left and still there. And they can still see it. They can still feel you for some of you. Some of you, they want to smell you. Like, there's something about your smell. They want to feel, touch, and smell you. Some of you, they really want to get you pregnant because mama's hand is on right now. They really are thinking about getting you pregnant. They've done this in a past life before. You've had a child with this person in the past life. I feel like this person knows this. For some of you, they've been shown this in a dream. I heard dream state. They know you in a dream state. Someone's ready to jump off that cliff and just say what they want to say. Whether it hurts or not. Like, they've been hurt. They've been stuck in these prickly bushes for so long and holding on to their truth for so long. It's put them in this sorrow state. I can't take this shit anymore. It could be a water sign that's coming in that left you out in the cold that wants to give you an offer. I heard a new start. Excuse me, they're worried about this. Excuse me. They're very up in their head about this. They're very up in their head about coming back. They're being very sneaky. They're trying to sneak past someone. For some of you, this person's is working on sneaking past someone. They might be trying to, like, sneak away from somebody. They're working on this. Like, they're sneaking away. They might be trying to gather some stuff and sneak away. They might even come towards you and, like, they're hiding this. They might even come towards you and hide this for a little bit. Because they know if they, other people know if they work, they're working on something with someone else, they're going to try to come in and fuck this up. So when this person comes in, if they ask you to keep it hush hush, just understand that not everything you need to be out here telling everybody about your stuff. Like, that's how so many people get fucked over. That's how so many people ruin relationships. Like, these people don't want to see you two together, so they're going to try to throw something at you. They're going to try to fuck up your relationship. This is definitely a twin flame for you. Don't let this person, these people stop you. Like, there's something very honoring about this person. That this person definitely feels like a wish fulfillment to you. Like, they want to come in and take this away from you. So don't, like I said, don't blast this all over Facebook. Like, you don't need to tell everybody your truth. You don't need to tell everybody who you're with. Like, hold this under lock and key for a little bit. What they don't know, they can't destroy. Yeah. Speak the truth. Love and light.